with this old capacitor based generator. At the suggestion of another YouTuber, I'm going ahead and replacing the capacitor. I will say that I believe this capacitor is done. It's melted. I glanced at it the other day, I didn't notice the melting, but I ran it for a good 4 hours straight, running some pretty high amperage, and it only runs on my shop vac. Smaller tools it didn't at all, so ordered a new capacitor off of Amazon. So the new one is pretty much identical. They're both rated at 24 microfarads, 350 volts. This one's new, one's melted. I'm not going to give you the boring details on actually screwing it back into place, but this even comes with the same tab for screwing it back into place. Alright, it's back in place. Old electrical tape in here. I'll be pulling out the speaker back together and
last 6 months, this old brushless generator has intermittently given me problems. Sometimes it would power my tools, sometimes it would not. My high amperage shop vac worked fine until last week. Over the last 4 or 5 months, the generator failed to power my drill or sawzall. Research indicated from my symptoms it was likely a bad capacitor that excites the field windings. This guess was backed up by ShawnMrFixItLee, see his link, and so I ordered a replacement and a spare. Sure enough, this fixed my generator's ailments, and I'm back in business for job sites that don't have accessible power.